Welcome to Alfheim, gentlemen. Think you can spot the light? I can barely see it. Something's wrong. See that column of light on the horizon? It's housed in the heart of a ring temple. We'll find what we need there. No. No, no, no. Damn it, not yet.
What's happening?
To restore the Bifrost magic, you must step into the light. But be very careful not to get it wrong.
She's not dead, is she?
Not likely. Come.
Look at this place.
Stay by me. Touch nothing.
Okay. What is that? I think you killed it.
Look up there!
Whoa, what's that about?
Not our concern, boy. Focus. What does it say?
Something about an eternal war for the light. I don't get it. If both sides need it, why not just share it?
Greed. You will find it a common cause for war.
They keep murdering the light elves.
It is war. The end of one. The robed ones lost.
Attacking us for? We didn't do anything.
More will come.
Ugh. Where's this stuff even come from?
Did you say something?
No.
Oh, okay. Cipher piece. I'll see what I can fit together.
At least we're getting closer to the light.
Wait, is that Sindri?
Huh! How are you here before us, dwarf? We were told our path was the only one between realms.
Well, it may be the only way for you to travel, but we dwarves are full of surprises.
That is not an answer.
Ah, hang on to that sense of wonder. There's so little mystery once you've amassed the wealth of arcane knowledge that I have. Where to comb the realms for exotic resources, how to craft them into creations that defy imagination. To the novice, I'm sure it all seems like magic, but... Oh, all right. It's magic. Are you happy now?
Did you really make that axe for my mother?
Oh, I'd recognize it anywhere. Ask me. It's one of our best. Infused with the echoing screams of 20 frost trolls. Give or take.
But why her? How did you know her?
She sought us out in the beginning. She was a special woman. She wanted to protect people. I suppose we thought it was a chance to give power to someone who'd use it for good. She even spoke our native tongue. She'd say, Madhurin sem Gengur, Egen Vigum Hans.
Gengur An.
That's right. That's impressive. I see a lot of her in your eyes. You know?
Thanks, Sindri.
Don't touch me.
What? I didn't. I won't. I'll come back later.
Be careful where you're going. There's nobody nice out here anymore since all the people left. I mean, I hate to generalize, but, mostly they just try to kill you.
Good tip.
I know it's not my business, but if I were you, I'd wash off that symbol painted on your neck.
We were told it would help protect us. Was that a lie?
Oh, no, it's a protection stave, all right, but you can't render that pigment into paintable texture without blending it with boar urine. And is that really better than death?
Maybe a little.
Well, it's your neck. Ugh.
Sindri, have you always been so...
clean? Huh. Don't I wish. No, I was just as unsanitary as the next dwarf until the day a Vanir witch set me straight. She discovered with her magic there are hundreds of thousands of tiny beasties on everything around us. Ugh. So small you can't even see them.
No.
It's true! And if they get inside you, they make you sick. But the witch told me there's one wood, the oak, that's a natural deterrent. Stops the beasties from spreading. So now, I make all my handles from oak. See? I think of these things. Okay, back to work.
So how come Brock's blue and you're not?
Why?
Oh, it's fine. Very good question, actually. You see, my brother's not as careful as I am. In fact, he prefers to work with metals using... his own bare hands. Ugh. No gloves. Says it's the only way he can hear what it wants to be. Touch enough raw silver and it changes your skin irreparably. That means forever. I wouldn't bring it up to him, though. You know how sensitive he can be.
I guess that makes sense. Sindri, why don't you just make up with your brother already?
Me? Make up with him? Because he's an obstinate pighead incapable of change. Because he says the most terrible things about me. Just because he's insecure about his own work. Which, let me tell you, is subpar. Because he blames me for the things that aren't my fault.
Huh? Like what?
Would you pardon me, please? I need to collect myself. Oh, I could use a distraction. How about you, young one? Ooh, what more do you need? brother lay his hands on again, but if he does, tell him to temper his steel longer. He's warping the bit work. And what can I do for you? Anything you need, young sir. Don't forget to wash your hands.
Look, there's a boat tangled up over. What'd you say?
I said nothing.
Really? Okay.
Did your mother speak of this realm?
Not much. Just that since the elves are always fighting over the light, they kept them isolated.
Again, I said nothing.
Wait, could have sworn you said something.
What is it, boy?
Voices! You don't hear that?
I hear nothing.
It's going away now.
It was screaming. Lots of voices. Angry. You really didn't hear that?
No.
It felt evil.
Look, should we try talking to them?
No.
But maybe they need help.
They do not stop us. So they do not concern us.
But
they
maybe
do not concern us.
Must be the Ring Temple.
It's sad the elves can't work things out. Alfheim's such a beautiful place, but war makes it ugly.
You see with the eyes of a child. In war, a soldier sees beauty only in the blood of his enemy. The rest of him is lost, sometimes never to return.
You... The blue door! That's gotta be the entrance. Let's go!
Careful, boy.
What are they doing? The bridge is gone. We covered the crystal with that stuff. Why?
To prevent reinforcements.
Maybe we can fix the bridge from down there? Okay, so that did something, I think.
Doctor, watch it!
Ready to go! What is their problem with us?
We do not belong here.
Wait, combined together like that, they kind of look like a room. It doesn't make sense.
Come. Back to the boat.
What else were you going to tell me about war?
Wars are fought for two things, survival or advantage. Battles may be won by the better soldier. Enough. Stories are for the boat. We must focus.
Father, the pillars and ring form an elvish rune.
What does it ask?
Without me or within me, death is sure. Yet within you, I am life most pure.
Yep, it's water, all right.
Boy!
It was the voices again, but different voices. Less angry. They were asking for help.
We are here for the light. I do not care who they are, nor what they want.
You never care about anything.
You have something to say?
No. Luger. What's happening? Whoa! Look what we found!
Father?
Yes?
The voices I heard. It was hard to make out, but way in the back I'm pretty sure I heard Mother.
That is not possible.
But I know what I heard.
Atreus, enough.
He looks different. Look at those horns.
Behind me, boy.
That can't be good.
Stay away from those cages.
Wonder why they're locked up.
Be ready.
What?
Father, you're really hurt! That was worth it. Father, take a look at this.
Go! Atreus, to me.
Okay. Tricky. Very tricky.
Think that side hallway will get us to the temple?
We will find out.
You were wrong back there.
Oh?
I know Mother's voice better than anyone. It was her.
She is gone, boy. Speak no more of this.
Fine.
Boys, fight!
Father, run!
No way across here. Too bad the witch's bowstring doesn't work anymore. You sure the witch is okay? I'd hate to think she died helping us.
She knew what she was doing.
Okay. That didn't work. Ugh, more of it.
If we cut enough away, the bridge above us should reappear.
Right.
Expect resistance.
Right.
Focus up!